Jonathan here. I teach high school wood shop, advanced manufacturing, CNC manufacturing, and woodworking at the community college. A couple of things I won't give an inch on in my class, and that's safety and measurement. Every student has to leave with a good understanding of safe practices and how to measure. You would think in high school students would be good at measurement, but in fact it's surprising how poor their measurement skills are, what tolerances they're working to. Are they building a Swiss watch or are they framing a house? What complementary means, how angles work, all of that stuff I really try and lay out for them. And I do a lot of it in the classroom. And I try not to do it for more than 10, 15 minutes a day, but I do try and do it regularly. So I have every student make sure they always have a nice sharp pencil. They have their own tape. It should be like a calculator in math class. They should know this tape. Is it a framing tape? Is it in 16ths? Or is it a cabinet maker's tape in the 32nds for the first 6 inches or first foot? How they could figure that out, they could just count the total marks up. And if they're 32 in an inch, it's in 32nds. If they're 16 in an inch, then it's in 16ths. So they should get to know their tape well. A speed square, I like using this in the classroom a lot because when we get on a job site, it goes every which way. Like some kids think it's a pry bar. And then a caliper, I really like these calipers to a thousandths of an inch. I only use dial calipers to a thousandths of an inch. I don't use digital calipers anymore, just so they really get an understanding that every rotation is a tenth of an inch. So I use these tools a lot in the classroom, not for long, but just repeatedly again and again. So some of the things I do when they have their tools is I have them cut a board, say 8.5 by 13, get a sheet of printer paper, and tape it down to that board. Once that sheet of paper is taped down to that board, I just give them some measurements. Draw two lines, one that's 5 1/4 inch long, one that's 6.5 inch long, and create an angle of 23 degrees in between those two lines. And so you grab your speed square. You want to come down 5 1/4. Well, you can see here that the tick marks on this rule on my speed square, there's only 8 of them. So that means each one's an eighth. So 5 1/4, I start right here at this point, and I go to 5 1/2, 5 1/4. Okay, then the next thing I need to do, this is 5 1/4 of an inch long, so I need to set a 27 degree angle. So I'm looking up here, see how this thing says pivot? That goes on my vertex. I really like it if you could use both math classroom speech and woodshop speech. So, you know, calling that a vertex, all your math teachers will be happy when you do that. So my pivot point goes on the vertex. I'm going to move this thing over or pivot it over to 27 degrees. And I can see there's 25, right? I'm going up this way. Each one of these is a single degree. So 25, 26, 27 degrees. I set it there, I hold it firmly, and I want to go 6.5 inches. Whoops, 27 degrees, and I go 6.5 inches. So this is my 6.5 inch line. This is my 27 degree line. You know, then I have them swap them out and another student check them. So, you know, another check you could do here is you could just drop in a vertical, create a right triangle. So that little box right there means 90 degrees or a right triangle. And then if I'm looking at this angle right here should be the complement of this angle. So a couple things you should know about angle measurement and drawing is that all three angles add to 180 degrees. Special kind of triangle is a 90 degree triangle. So if I know one of these are 90, these two together have to be 90. That's called complementary. So complementary angles are two angles that add to 90 degrees. Supplementary are angles that add to 180. So our angles that add to 180 degrees. So those are just some math terms that you should incorporate in your measurement. A right triangle, complementary, supplementary. And as I'm just looking at this picture, I could see that this 6.5, you know, looks like 6.5 compared to that 5.25. This angle right here does look a lot bigger than this angle right here, 27 degrees. So, in fact, this angle should be 63 degrees because it is a complement of this acute angle of 27 degrees. So, acute means less than 90 degrees, and obtuse means greater than 90 degrees, and then right means exactly 90 degrees. And then, you know, you could do a lot with Pythagorean theorem on this. Maybe I'll do that in a separate video, but I'll take this triangle and I'll measure the pieces and parts with my tape and see if I could use the Pythagorean theorem to see if all these pieces are correct. So this is just an overview and measurement, how to get students using a speed square and their tape in class, learning a little bit of angle measurement terminology that helps on any job site, but also in a math classroom and even on a standardized math test. So again, I don't do this very often. I mean, I do this very often in the class, but not for very long. So sometimes you just draw out a couple quick lengths and angles and check them, and then we're out in the shop within 10-15 minutes. So it's a nice way to use measurement in any shop classroom.